When you hear the word treehouse, you'd probably think of something like this or this. However, I only recently found out there are treehouses in the UK that you can actually stay in. So that is exactly what I'm going to be doing today. I found a treehouse which I think looks insane. Whilst researching this video, I came across a UFO treehouse in Sweden. If we can get 36,000 likes in this video, I will travel to the UFO and stay there for a couple of days as soon as I can.
So as you can see, this is actually the place, the Lost Meadow Tree Pod. It looks insane. It is floating from the trees. Well, it's not quite floating, it's hanging. £105 a night, I don't think that's too bad.
However, there is one small issue, and that is, it's quite far away. Very far away.
It is 4 hours and 2 minutes away, 227 miles, all the way down in Cornwall.
I was supposed to be going with Glenn, but he woke up today feeling like absolute shit. Luckily, I persuaded my friend Finn to come. I did have to give him a bit of cash incentive. Yeah, that's how good all my friends are.
Of course, I'm going to be taking this laptop with me, this HP, which I will show you and talk to you guys more about later on in the video. Are you ready?
No, not at all.
The weather is not too great right now. We have light showers, a bit of sun though. Although we are driving 4 hours, so it could completely change. But yeah, I'm gonna go pick up Finn, and then we're gonna begin the journey of hell. Hi!
Let's go to Cornwall.
Okay, so we're driving for a solid 30 minutes and Finn already needed to stop for a piss, and we have now also maybe got Subway. So yeah, looks like we're gonna be very, very late. At this rate, we're literally gonna get there after sunset, so I don't know if we're actually gonna be able to find it, but that's gonna be part of the fun. It's an adventure. Maybe it was a bad idea to stop. Finn, you should just held it in.
Oh no, we've just got back to the car. It says we're gonna get there at 7:20. We've still got 3 hours and 28 left to drive. Oh my days. All right, let's get this show on the road.
We're about 43 minutes away now. The weather has taken a turn. It is absolutely pouring it down. I don't know how we're supposed to make a fire when it's been raining so much, but hopefully there's one inside or something. And as you can probably hear, it is pouring down again. Oh my God. Oh my days. We have hit the perfect time to go to the woods.
I should have stayed at home. It was nice and warm there.
First petrol station of the trip.
What is that? That isn't a road. I'm just praying we somehow actually find this place. We are in the middle of nowhere. Like, I'm driving down a single track road and I can't even see where the road is going right now.
Yeah, no, come a bit further up past Lost Meadow Gallery.
Unsuitable for motor vehicles. I'm pretty sure this is a motor vehicle, right?
Well, yeah.
Great. You can just about see it, but that is the little tree pod right there.
So sick.
After you, Finley.
I'll just show one of you a little bit tight.
All right, well, Finn's gonna go up at me. I'm so annoyed we got here late and it's dark so you can barely see, but look at this pod, it is actually floating. Oh, okay, it's not quite floating. There is a little thing underneath it. Little staircase next to it as well. We are properly in the woods. Like, you obviously cannot see anything. And then we have this little shed next to us where we can cook, sit, chill. I don't know, we're basically camping. It's now time. I'm gonna go up into the little pod, go check it out. Ah, these stairs are so narrow. Here we are, first time seeing the inside of the pot. Oh, almost fell over. Wow, what is this? This is so interesting. What the hell? This is so cool. Mate.
So, the beds fold out, he was showing me.
Yeah.
These little, like, hold on, I'll take my shoes
off. Show me how it works, Finley. Oh my, yeah, shut up, dangles. It moves.
Yeah.
Oh my God, no, bro, allow that.
So apparently, these are...
How are you ignoring the fact it's wobbling?
Bro, you just gotta deal with it.
I actually like it. Like, it is cool.
Proper vibes.
It is vibes, yeah. This is cute. We're on a little date right now, Finn.
Oh, that's really romantic.
Yeah, it is romantic. I just really don't feel easy about how much this thing is shaking right now.
Wait, where do you reckon they made this? So you can, like, buy one of these?
Yeah, mate, just get an Amazon next day delivery.
Finn has properly folded out his bed. That actually looks quite spacious, you know?
It's quite good. It looks like a pea in a pod.
It's not that cold either.
No, it was quite warm. He said you might not even need the fire.
Wow. And there is also a fire, so we can light a fire. I literally asked Finn last minute this morning, and he somehow said yes.
I don't know how I said yeah, but here we are.
Well, I did offer to pay you.
Yeah, that's true.
What? I'm gonna get seasick.
I need to go and get my stuff from the car.
Anyways, the plan is to go to the shop. We're gonna get some food, get some marshmallows, get some drinks. It's like glamping, but not that glorious.
Glamorous.
Glorious. Not that glamorous.
So this is how the bed starts its life as a sofa, and then you fold it out, and voila, you have a full-on bed. Oh, we have a sink?
Are you saying it's for, like, brushing your teeth?
Oh, and so we don't even need to go to the toilets,
it's
really.
It's got a little pump action.
Oh, that is quite cool.
So it doesn't really work that well.
There is, like, a toilet and shower block, but it's about 5 minutes away where the car is. I can't wait to see what it actually looks like in the day. It's going to be amazing.
I've got my lantern. I've got the most booty shoes I own.
And we are back in the car. I finally feel safe again. I even used to go to Scouts, yet I'm still here being a pussy about spending a night in the woods. I have now become a city person. I don't like it. I should not be scared in nature. Nothing is going to happen.
It's a fat Morrison.
It is a very fat Morrison.
Where we are, this is massive.
Considering we're in the middle of nowhere.
We probably passed about 3 different cars on the whole 15-minute journey here. That is how quiet it is.
Got myself 2 little vegan burgers. Not sure what they're going to taste like, but we're going to find out. Somehow just spent £22 on shopping for tonight. I don't know how that's possible, but we have a lot of snacks and marshmallows, very important. Okay, so we've now arrived back at the place. We are just walking through the woods, well, through a field right now. We're about to go through the woods and then we arrive at the pod. Obviously, you cannot see anything. And there she is back at the pod, but you can barely see it.
It's not warm outside right now. It's actually quite cold, hence why you can see my breath right in front of me. Makes sense.
Oh, that gives me so much anxiety. Stop that. Now, stop that. You're going to cut yourself. Mate, why do people live in mansions with big kitchens?
And they can live in a pond in a tree.
Exactly. We did not forget the marshmallows. We've got some kindling. How do you say it? Kindling. We've got some actual big logs down there as well. There's even a whole tank of fresh water. As you can see, I have a nice little glass of water. Try some. Let me know what you think.
Oh, that's crisp and fresh.
These vegan no duck spring rolls are actually really good. I don't know what they put in it. If there's not duck, I guess there's just not duck. Chef Finn has absolutely smashed it. First try of the burger. Let us know what you think. You're not even a vegan, yet you're having vegan burgers. Oh, that is not the face.
That's not great either.
That's not great, is it not?
It's not bad. It's not great. Also, there is absolutely no connection here. I can't text anyone. I can't call anyone. I can't go on Instagram. I can't do anything. I'm completely disconnected right now.
I was just talking about how we could put the marshmallows on these little spike like kebab skewers we have, and I then dropped them all on the floor. All right, so I'm now back inside the pod. I'm gonna try and start a fire. It's slightly chilly in here and I could do with a bit of heat, so hopefully I'll be able to get something started. I will be back in one moment. And just like that, we have got a fire. It's literally just started though. I don't know if this will stay lit.
It's lit.
It's lit. Fuck, we are such virgins, bro. I don't want to make too much smoke because I think there's a smoke alarm in here. Oh, that looks like it's working. Yeah, there we go. That looks all right. Let me just move that there. I'm a pyromaniac. I actually love fires. I used to love going to Scouts just because I can make fires and play with knives. The Doritos have come out. The dips have come out. The marshmallows have also come out. And the fire is going well. It's actually a really nice vibe in here right now, genuinely. Okay, so I've got my laptop out. We're about to watch a movie.
Sorry to interrupt, but seeing as I just mentioned my laptop, I feel like it'd be unfair to not tell you guys about it. This is a HP Envy 13, which is making my life easier on a daily basis. I can take it literally anywhere with me. It just slides in and out of my bag. Look how small it is. I'm sure a lot of you guys out there are studying and it's so important to have a computer which can keep up with what you need to be doing. It has an Intel i7 processor in, which may mean nothing to you. It's among one of the fastest processors you can actually get in a laptop, which just means it's going to be fast. The worst thing about technology is when it restricts you and when it wastes your time. It also has Intel Iris Plus graphics, which allows you to game, create, browse, stream. It's not going to have any issues and it won't let you down. And last but not least, it is touchscreen, which means I can browse on the internet, scrolling through the screen with my finger, which is very useful. Not many laptops have it, and it's such a good feature. I love it. It has a full HD micro edge touch display, which is perfect for a 13-inch laptop. All of that in such a small package meant I was able to stay on top of all my work whilst in the middle of a woods, transferring files from the camera, watching a movie, and of course, doing top secret work that I can't talk about. Maybe it wasn't top secret, I just can't remember what I was actually doing. If you buy a qualifying HP Envy or Spectre laptop, HP will donate £200 worth of equipment and laptops to a school of your choice, so you're doing some good in the world. That is a win-win situation there. You get good karma and a good laptop. What more could you want? Check out the link in the description to find out more info on that amazing laptop. Thank you so much to HP for sponsoring this video. Let's get back to the treehouse.
This is honestly like camping on a boat right now. The amount it's shaking.
No, I dropped my marshmallows again.
Wow, that is so good. It's now the morning. I've woken up in a pod, in a tree. I don't know where I am. We did actually start watching a movie last night, and the reason why I didn't say goodnight is because I fell asleep within the first 5 minutes of the film. I don't know how I managed that, but I was straight out cold. And yeah, I've just woken up. I might also go for a shower and have a little walk around, see what it's actually like in the daytime.
This is currently the vibes. Oh, Finn, what are you saying?
Big vibes.
Big vibes.
There's even a little window in the roof, and you know what we realised? This little pod is actually a company. As you can see, one sec, it says tree tent right there. And Finn reckons this thing costs 50 grand.
I reckon it's 50 bags.
I don't think there's any way this pod could cost more than 10 grand. But yeah, we're gonna try look online because Finn thinks it's 50 grand. I think it's about 10 grand. We're gonna try and squash the beef. Whoever's wrong has to pay for the petrol home. You down for that?
Yeah, I'm actually down.
I basically found the price of the tree pods and I hate to break it to you, but I win.
What? Yeah. Cost 50 grand.
So it costs 19 grand plus VAT plus like 2.5 grand delivery.
Oh yeah, I owe you the fuel money.
Yeah.
Well that sucks. Yeah, see you later, Ben. I've got to go now.
I have a nice little view into the woods. I mean, you can't really see much, but I can see trees and green. That makes me happy.
I see trees of green.
Fear, how does it go?
I see trees of green.
We also have no idea what to do today because I'm not driving all the way to Cornwall to not actually do something while I'm here other than stay in this treehouse. We might also find somewhere nice to go for food.
Okay, so I'm just walking through the woods now on my way to the shower. Look how nice and tranquil this is. As you can see, the river is right here. It runs all the way down through the woods. And then you have to walk through this massive field and all the way out this path to get to where the car is. However, I have just spotted down here. Yeah, they are definitely chickens. Oh, hello. Hello, chickens. How are you? What are you saying? Oh, sorry, I'm gonna give the chickens COVID. What are you guys up to today, huh? Not much.
Anyways, let's go check out the shower block, the facilities. Let's just go over a word I can't actually pronounce. It's basically camping, just not in a tent, in a pod. And you have a little shed to cook in as well. And it's actually not that cheap, but it's cool.
And here's the car, which is so ridiculously dirty because of where we've been driving, but it's fine. I can get it cleaned, it's not the end of the world. And in here are the showers slash toilets. Let me quickly show you guys inside. How am I supposed to open this? We haven't been given a key. Why is it locked? Nah, you have to be kidding. I've just walked the whole way here.
Looks like I just completely wasted my time walking to the toilets and showers for them not even to be open. I don't know how he expects me to get in when I don't have a key. Maybe he did actually give us a key, but I don't remember him telling us he did.
Back down this path, through the field, into the woods. Are you guys ready for the big reveal of the treehouse pod? It is right in front of, okay, you've already seen it. Here it is. In the daylight, in all its glory, a literal floating, well, I thought it was a floating pod until I saw this little log down here. I think this is the main support. As you can see, there is like metal attachments and stuff, but there is like 3 or 4 wires attached from the top of the pod to these two trees. There is also straps on either side, so I'm not sure what is actually holding it up, but I felt pretty safe last night. That is the one window. There is the chimney for the fire. It looks so f***ing cool. Imagine you're just going for a little stroll through the woods and you come across this thing. Like, what are you thinking? And this is all the wood space that we have around us. The river is literally down there. There's also a pit where you can have like a campfire with your mates or something, some little logs to sit on. It is honestly such a beautiful place to be. And then you turn around and right behind you is a hanging tree pod.
Don't get me wrong, the drive here was so long, but once you're here at the pod, it's just so nice and relaxing. I'm clearing my head right now of all the YouTube stress I have. That was a joke. We don't actually get stressed because we don't have a real job.
What a little cool pod this thing is. Chef Finley has been back at it again. He has made some hot cross buns.
They're not even great.
Breakfast, I guess. Very nice. Thank you, Finley.
They're not too bad.
And there we go. One night at tree pod in the middle of the woods, complete. Look at this place, it's actually insane. We still need to find out if you can actually buy one of these structures and how much they cost. I want to know how much money these people are making. Final goodbyes to the little TARDIS pod, whatever you want to call this thing. And exit. And there it is, the almighty pod Goodbye, you were fun.
We're now gonna go to the lake that we drove past yesterday. I was actually supposed to be staying for longer. Finn needs to be back in London tonight, and if I'm honest, I probably wouldn't stay here alone. I'd be really scared. I'm such a pussy.
Had a good time?
I vibed with it. I thought it was cool. I'd probably come back here.
The shed has been closed up. We've got all our belongings, the camera gear, etc. It has been very real pod. However, now we're gonna go fly the drone and check out a bit of Cornwall.
It's called Colliford Lake. It is 13 minutes away. And yeah, we're gonna get on our way because time is money and I don't have much money. And we have arrived at the lake. Look at that. That is quite a wham lake if I've ever seen one. Mr. Finley is setting up the drone. If any of you guys have been watching my videos for a very long time, you'll remember when Finn flew his drone in my Living Like Casey Neistat for a Week video.
Yeah, that was...
Do you remember that?
That was so long ago.
The drone is now in the air, as you might be able to hear, so we are going to switch to the drone. There we go, successful flight. If any of the shots are bad, blame Finn, not me. Yeah. Okay, so at this point, I don't really know what we should do. I wanna go to the Eden Project. If you've never heard of it before, this is basically it. It's a, I think it's like a botanical garden, conservation area thing, bubbles. I don't know how to explain it. The only issue is it costs £30 per person. And if we're only going for like an hour, that's not really worth it. So I think instead we might just go get some food.
Yeah, let's get some food.
Okay, Finn really wants to get some food, so looks like we're gonna go get some food.
So the closest food place to us right now is called Jamaica Inn Restaurant, and it has 4,855 ratings.
Oh no!
And that is on maturity and ruining my car with a load of stone chips. It is what it is.
And here we are at Jamaica's Inn. Look how busy the car park is. Like, we haven't seen any cars, yet this place is heaving. There's also a farm shop and a gift shop, and yeah, we're gonna get some food.
What is this guy doing? Press button. Okay, if you say so. Hello?
So anticlimactic.
Yeah, anything gonna happen? That looks like a cool Ouija board. Look at that, we have just got our food. How's yours looking, Finn? Whoa, you have just put a lot of salt in there, mate. We've also just been told how haunted this place actually is. I didn't realize. One of the staff said she'd been working here for 2 weeks and she's already had her hair pulled by a ghost or something like that. I don't know how much of that I actually believe in, but yeah, I'm gonna eat my food. I'm not really bothered.
Get ready to fill my stomach. Okay, so that was so, so good. Which way do you wanna go, lad?
You're in the stocks at the Jamaica Inn.
Oh no, ah.
And finally, we're gonna check out the farm shop because we haven't looked inside yet. And we've ended up leaving with strawberry and cream fudge. Is it fudge? 2 hours left of the journey. However, I've just quickly stopped in Bristol because I wanted to come back to the Clifton Bridge. I love this place so much. Look how cool that bridge is, and Bristol is actually such a sick place as well. We are about to leave though because Finn needs to be home for about 8 p.m. And yeah, we're not gonna make it on time, which isn't my fault. Maybe it is.
God damn it. And yeah, I drove back to London, got Chipotle, picked up my cat. This is the end of the video. I'm so sorry to break it to you. 36,000 likes and I'll go stay in that UFO in Sweden. Thank you so much to HP for sponsoring today's video. If you want to find out more about the laptop, check the link down below. Subscribe, comment, all of that stuff. I will see you guys very soon. Goodbye.